Hello everyone, I welcome you again to my channel Pharma Guide. Today we'll study about the working and principle of the tablet compression machine. Okay, if you're watching my videos for the first time, please subscribe to my channel, and at the end, if you like content of my video, please don't forget to like it and share it. Okay, now what is compression? Compression is defined as reduction in the bulk volume of the powder owing to the application of the forces. So when the force is applied to the powder, its bulk volume is reduced. How this force is applied? The compression takes place in a die by the action of two punches. This is a die, and the compression takes place by the action of the two punches. This is the upper punch and this is the lower punch, and this will apply the compression force. Now we'll see how what is the tableting cycle. The process of the tableting can be divided into four stages, or the compaction cycle can be divided into four stages. First is the die filling. Okay, so this is the die. Powder is fed into this die. How? This is normally accomplished by the gravitational flow of the powder from a hopper via die table into the die. So these are attached to a die table, and the flow of the powder takes place from the hopper into the die. Now this die, it is closed at the lower end by the lower punch. Now the position of the lower punch in the die is responsible for the volume of the cavity. This is important, that position of this lower punch in the die, it will decide the die fill, or what amount of granules are to be filled into the die. For example, we can say that this punch comes to this height. Okay, so this much amount of granules will be filled. So position of the lower punch in the die is responsible for the volume of the cavity. The volume must be appropriately adjusted for the weight of the granules to be compressed to make the tablets. So height of this lower punch is adjusted in the die, okay, and to get the appropriate weight of the granules to be compressed to make a tablet. Now what is metering? Next step, first is the die filling will take place. Now next step is the metering. Now metering involves the removal of the excess granules from the compression machine. The excess granules here are scrapped. Okay, so this lower punch, this is attached to a metering cam. Okay, at this stage, the required weight or volume of the granules to be compressed into the tablet is controlled by the height of the lower punch in the die. And the height of the lower punch is controlled by the metering cam. Okay, so this lower punch is attached to a metering cam, and this will decide that what will be the height of this lower punch in this die, and height of the lower punch in this die will decide what will be the die fill, or what amount of granules will be filled into the die. So we will adjust the height of this lower punch in the die so that the appropriate amount of the granules can be filled into the die to make a tablet of the desired weight. Okay, now the lower punch is raised to a required level in the die to get the required weight of the granules in the die punch cavity. The excess granules are scrapped from the surface of the die table. The excess of the granules are scrapped from this surface to get the appropriate amount of granules into the die cavity. Now today, the automatic weight control machines, these are used for the better results. Machines are automated weight control unit. The compression, third step after the first is the die filling, then the metering, then third step is the compression. Okay, upper punch descends and enter into the die, and the powder is compressed until the tablet is formed. Now this upper punch, this will descend down into the die cavity to compress this powder to make the tablet. Now during the compression phase, the lower punch can be stationary or it can move upwards. This lower punch, it can be stationary in the die, or it can also move upwards. This upper punch will move downward and this lower punch will move upward. Now this lower punch remains stationary in the single punch machines, and in the multi-stationary machines, rotary press, lower punch moves upwards and the upper punch move downwards. So during the compression phase, the lower punch can be stationary or it can move upwards in the die. Now after the maximum force is reached, the upper punch leaves the powder, that is the decompression phase. Now when the maximum force is applied by these punches to make the tablet, this upper punch will go upwards, or it will leave this die. This is called the decompression phase. We will discuss this decompression phase in the next coming slides. Fourth is the tablet ejection, or last step is the tablet ejection then. Now in this stage, the upper punch retracts from the die cavity and rises above the turret table. Okay, turret table is the table where all the dies are attached, or this is the die table. Okay. In this stage, the upper punch retracts from the die cavity and rises above the turret table. This above upper punch will go up, then the lower punch rises in the die, okay, which in turn pushes the tablets upward to the top surface of the die table. Okay, this upper punch will move upward and this lower punch will move upwards till top of the die, and with this lower punch tablet will also move upwards. When the tablet come here, the scrapper will scrap the tablets or collect the tablets into the containers. Now the event that occurs in the process of compression, or what is the physics involved in the process of compression, what actually happens within the die cavity? First of all, the transitional repackaging, packing, or the particle rearrangement takes place within the die cavity. Then the deformation at the point of contact. Deformation means change in the shape of the particles in the at the point of contact. Then the fragmentation of or the deformation, elastic or the plastic deformation or fragmentation may occur. Then bonding between the particle takes place, which leads to the deformation of the solid body or formation of the tablet occurs. Then decompression phase, and finally the ejection of the tablet. We'll study this in detail now, what actually happens within the die cavity. Now the basic mechanical unit in the compression, in the tablet compression, involves the operation of two steel punches, that is the upper punch and the lower punch, within the steel die cavity. Now the tablet is formed by the pressure exerted on the granulation by the punches within the die cavity. The tablet assumes the shape, size of the punches and the dies used. So the tablet formed is according to the shape and size of the punches and the dies which we use. First of all, what happens in the die cavity? Particle rearrangement. Now, during the compaction of the powder particles, the air between the particles and the air in the pores of the particles squeezes, and the solid particles, they get closer to each other, thus decreasing their movement and the ordering ability. First of all, the air which is entrapped within the particles and in the pores of the particles, it is squeezes when the compression force is applied, and these particles, they rearrange themselves, and the what happens then the volume will be reduced and their moving ability and their ordering ability will also reduced. Now at a definite pressure, the movement of the particles become impossible. Now at a definite pressure, these particles, now they cannot move. Then further increase in the compression, if the compression force is further increased, it causes the deformation at the point of contact. So you can see, now when the force is applied to the particles, first of all the air within the particles and in the pores of the particles, it squeezes, and the particles, they rearrange, they move themselves in the die cavity. Now at a definite pressure, these particles cannot move. If the pressure is increased above that pressure, then the deformation or change in the shape of the particle occur at the point of the contact. Now deformation at the point of contact occur, it can be this deformation, this can be elastic deformation, or it can be plastic deformation. If this deformation disappears completely when we remove the stress, or when the upper punch will go up, if these particles come back to their original shape, or you can say this deformation, this recovers completely, then this is the elastic deformation. Okay, if the deformation is disappear completely, return to the original shape upon the release of the stress, this is called the elastic deformation. What is plastic deformation? Deformation that does not completely recover after release of the stress is known as the plastic deformation. When the stress is released, this deformation does not recover completely. You can see the difference very clearly here. In the elastic deformation, these particles will come back to their original shape, or this deformation which occurred, this will relieve or recover completely. Then this is the plastic deformation. And when this deformation does not recover completely, this is the plastic deformation. Okay, this the plastic deformation is the ideal condition in the formation of the tablets. Now the force that is required to initiate the plastic deformation is called the yield stress. Force which is required to initiate this plastic deformation is called the yield stress. This plastic deformation is a time dependent process. Okay. This short compression time results in the weak binding force. Now if this compression cycle is very fast, okay, decompression will not take this decompression. This is a time dependent process. If this compression will be very fast or the short compression time, it will result in the weak bonding, because at the plastic deformation, what happens? The true area of contact increases and the particle binding occurs. Okay, so if this process is for the very short time, then weak binding will occur, or the this short compression time will result in the weak binding force. This phenomena is very critical, essentially in the case of the high speed tableting machines in the industry, where the dwell time of the particle during the compression is extremely short. In the industries, the speed of the machine is very high, and this dwell time, or the time for which the compression occurs, this is the very short. So it is a very critical step in the industries. Plastic deformation must occur. Okay. Now after the plastic deformation, when this plastic deformation occurs, that is what is the yield stress? The force required to initiate the plastic deformation is the yield stress. Now when this plastic deformation occurs, if we further increases the compression force, these particles will develop the bigger force to each other and the brittle fracture occurs. Now what happens? These particles, the stress within these particles will propagate enough to make the cracks. Fragmentation will occur. At the higher pressure, fracture occurs when the stress within the particle become great enough to propagate the cracks. Okay, so after the plastic deformation, if we will further increase the stress, what will happen? Fragmentation will occur. Fragmentation causes the further densification. Further densification of these particles, fragmentation causes the further densification with infiltration of the smaller fragments into the void space. Smaller fragments, they infiltrate into the void space and the cracks propagate. With some material, fragmentation does not occur because the stress are released by the plastic deformation. When we relieve the stress, some of the stress is released, or the some of the stress is recovered between the particles. So if this fragmentation does not occur with every material, even the plastic and the elastic deformation, this both occurs in the material, but one of them predominates, and for the formation of the tablets, this plastic deformation is the ideal condition. But if we further increases the force, then what happens? The brittle fracture or the fragmentation occurs. Now bonding between the particle occurs. Now there are several mechanisms of bonding in the compression forces. First is the solid bridges. As we apply the pressure, it may result in the melting at the at the point of contact of the particles, or there are many mechanisms like melting, crystallization, sintering, chemical reactions, and the binder hardening. Next is the bonding as a result of the movable liquid. Due to the presence of a liquid between the particles, the capillary and the surface tension forces, the bonding will occur. Non-freely movable binder bridges, viscous binder or the adsorption layer, this will result in bonding. Attraction between the solid particles like molecular and the electrostatic forces, van der Waals forces and electrostatic forces. Then the mechanical interlocking, this is what? Deformation or the irregular particle size and the shape and the size distribution. Now deformation of the solid body, this is the mechanism by which the bonding occurs between the particles. Now deformation of the solid body, as the pressure is further increased, the bonded solid, this the solid particles which are bonded, this is consolidated towards a limiting density. A compact of a limiting density is formed by the elastic or the plastic deformation of the tablet within the die cavity. A compact that solid is formed. Okay, so as the pressure is applied, is further increased, this bonded solid is consolidated towards a limiting density by the plastic or the elastic deformation of the tablet within the die. Now after this after the compression process, bonding and this consolidation, after the compression and consolidation, what decompression occurs? Okay, what is decompression? Now, the success or the failure to produce an intact tablet, it depends on the stress induced by the elastic rebound and associated deformation during the decompression and the ejection. The tablet which is formed, it must be able to withstand the stress which it will encounter during the decompression and the ejection. Now, when the stress is relieved or when the upper punch will relieve, some of the elastic rebound in the tablet will occur. When we will release the stress, which was compression force, or we can say compression force which we applied for the formation of the tablet, which we remove, when we remove the force or when we release the stress, some of the elastic rebound in the tablet will occur. As the upper punch is withdrawn from the die cavity, the tablet is confined in the die by the radial pressure. Okay, consequently, any dimensional change during the decompression must occur in the axial direction. Now, when the upper punch is removed, there is an elastic rebound in the axial direction. Now, the tablet, if this process is very fast, if this stress relaxation process or the removal of the stress is very fast, there will be fast elastic recovery and the tablet may break, it may cap or laminate. Okay. So this process, also must be slow, as the deformation is a time-dependent process, stress relaxation is also a time-dependent process. If we remove the stress very fast, some of the elastic rebound will occur in the axial direction, and this pressure will also propagate in this radial direction, will lead to the capping or the lamination. Okay, now ejection. What happens in ejection? The lower punch, it rises up. Okay. When the lower punch rises up, it pushes the tablet upwards and there is a continued residual die wall friction. As the lower punch rises up, it pushes the tablet upwards and there is a continued die wall pressure and the die wall friction. Okay. Now, as the tablet is removed from the die, the lateral pressure is relieved and the tablet undergoes the elastic recovery. When the tablet is removed from the die, some of the elastic recovery of the tablet occurs and there is 2 to 10% increase in the volume of that portion of the tablet removed from the die. So when the elastic recovery occurs, there is 2 to 10% increase in the volume. Now during the ejection, that the portion of the tablet inside the die or the tablet inside the die, it undergoes or it has certain strain. Okay. And if this strain within the tablet exceeds the strength of the tablet, or when this strain within the tablet, it increases, strain is more than the shear strength of the tablet, then this tablet will break during the elastic recovery. Okay. So when the tablet is ejected, it will face the die wall friction, and when the tablet come out of the die, it will undergo elastic recovery. And if this tablet, its strength is less, and if the strain within the tablet inside the die is more than the strength of the tablet will break during the elastic recovery. And if it will not break and the tablet is good, then when the tablet comes out, there is an elastic recovery and 2 to 10% increase in the volume of the tablet that is removed from the die. Okay, now you can see here, this is the, you can see this is elastic deformation. In elastic deformation, the shape is regained. In plastic deformation, stress recovery is not completely, or shape is not recovered completely. In the brittle fragmentation, the fragment, this cracks, they propagate in the tablet. Okay. Compression physics. First of all, what happens? The particle, they undergo rearrangement to the less porous structure. Then the deformation will occur and the bonding will occur. This bonding may be due to solid bridges, due to the intermolecular forces or the mechanical interlocking. Okay. After deformation, this deformation can be elastic deformation or plastic deformation. Plastic deformation is the ideal condition for the formation of the tablet. Then the decompression will occur and the ejection of the tablet will occur. Okay guys, thank you for your time and attention. If you like content of my videos, please like them and share them and subscribe to my channel PharmaGuide.